one off. It's the trooper.
Yo, got up today, enjoyed a little coffee right there in Trooper Cafe. What? Trooper Cafe is a small section of Casa del Trooper. That is where I make and drink and enjoy coffee. That's right. And watch a little YouTube to wake up. And sometimes when you wake up and that coffee maker's right there and you're just like, man, what a joyful experience. Trooper Cafe is the shit, as the kids say. Yo, let me start this out by apologizing to the fellas for starting the vlog in the shower. I did it for the ladies. And let me also apologize to the ladies for keeping it from here up. I did that for the fellas. You know, I'm trying to please everybody up in here. Look at them damn hot air balloons. There's hot air balloon rides right over there. Check it out. We should go on one of them shits. Trooper, trooper, zoom in. It's gonna be shaky zoomed in, but you get the drift. You get the picture, don't you? You know, I would go on one of them things, but one of them shits blazed up and crashed and burned in Texas not too long ago, didn't it? I think it did. I think I heard about that shit on the news. Should I go? Tell me, should I go? I got $100 off coupon. Got to be $300. Gotta be. $250. Minimum. You know what? Let's Google that shit. The weekday morning, I was right around it. It's $275. But they got a Christmas sale right now, $75 off. Weekend morning is $295. $75 off for Christmas. Winter afternoon flight is $325. $75 off for Christmas. I think I'd rather go on a helicopter ride. No? They got the helicopter tours that are, I think they're roughly the same price. Take a damn hill, not to Grand Canyon, but like Strip. I think if you go to the Grand Canyon, it's a lot more. Here we are at the Golden Nugget. So apparently I am the, listen, it's on one hand, it's funny. On the other hand, I don't like to give too much ridiculous shit, too much airtime in the vlog. But apparently, I'm the school bus bully or the, whatever the fuck it says. You know what? I'll actually give TBC a small piece of advice in this vlog if you're watching, and I do this out of kindness. Your biggest mistake last night in the game was assuming that my every thought revolved around you. It did not. I would never steal blinds in an uncapped 1-2 cash game. Who the fuck steals blinds in a cash game? I'm not a bully of any kind. I play poker, so I was trying to get the most money out of the game that I could get. Doesn't really matter. Lovely day out here on Fremont Street. I don't know if you noticed, but it's still daylight. You know I don't do daylight that much. I'm working on it though, I'm trying to do the daylight. Looks like it's about 52 degrees, not bad. All right, so right now during the day, the fucking line is still like it was yesterday. However, I think it may still be early enough that the other Starbucks is open. They do have two Starbucks, but the one over here closes earlier. Shit. Actually, I think they close at 4. Because the chick was back there counting the money in the register. It's just after 4 o'clock. It was a gamble to walk over here. Sure, I could have been in line already, but it's worth a check. Man, I love me some damn daytime casino action. Hey, the line's not protruding past the wall. All right, I got my fix right here.
So yeah, let's go see if there's a seat for me. Bored with the game at the Golden Nugget, and actually have been presented with two reasons to stop by Excalibur. So one of them is that I have that ticket from, I think it's Al, right? Thanks again, Al. I don't know why you would send me money or why anyone would, but I'm not gonna just let the casino keep it, so let's go cash it out. Find something productive to do with this. You know what? I'll buy myself and my friend Veronica coffee. Oh, who's Veronica? So this is my friend Veronica, all the way from Canada. She plays poker and she watches the vlog. So let's go that way.
Okay.
She wants to go play the tournament at Luxor, so.
We're walking there.
Yeah, we're walking there. So, and we're having coffee. Veronica likes Starbucks. And turns out Veronica has the same feelings as I do about moving sidewalks. And everyone's annoying as shit today. Oh, look at that. That one's broken.
Yeah, they broke the glass.
Oh, they broke the glass. Oh well.
Is that a long flight? I'm not telling secrets. I'm not allowed to. But I know it.
Fucking lens is it's not wide enough. Poker Kraut is sitting in the game, and so I don't know, they look like they're having fun, so I decided to sit in the game too. So now I'm playing at the Luxor. You know what I just realized? I only had toast to eat today. I'm freaking starving over here. Yeah, I said it. I'm starving. I'm gonna go hit the Starbucks and grab a quick little sandwich. Couldn't go to Starbucks and get a sandwich without another little coffee. I've had a lot of coffee today. I'm not gonna lie. This might not be the last one either. Don't tempt me to have more coffee, because I'll do it, because I'm a maniac. I just found a quarter on the floor at Luxor. That's right, a quarter. No, not a green chip. 25 cents. It's almost 1 o'clock in the morning. Minus $47, big whoop. So I, what does that mean for the day? Plus 117 at Golden Nugget, minus 47 here, that's plus 70, am I right? Is my calculator working right? I think it is. So I'm trying to think of a, I don't want to call it a challenge. Maybe it is a challenge. Maybe it's a goal challenge. Maybe it's a project. The fuck do I call this? I'm thinking about doing something. I'm thinking about changing my approach to poker. And I think that if I do this, it'll be exciting for the vlog. But like, I don't know. I'm thinking about maybe setting some small goals and then moving up in limits after each goal. And then if I lose a certain amount, go back down or whatever. Something that, it's something I was discussing with Patrick. Shouts out to Patrick at Bellagio the other day. And it just sort of gave me an idea that maybe I should do something like that. But it's just an idea that I have. I'm just thinking about it. I haven't been very concerned with moving up in stakes. And by the way, even if I did do something like this, it would really come down to the quality of the games. I mean, I hope you don't take offense to this. And if you do, sorry about it. But I fucking hate the smell of weed. I hate it. I just smelled weed all the way from the door of the shit to this shit. It smells fucking terrible. I guess it all comes down to risk versus reward. You know what I mean? And at the moment, I mean, every day there's a risk, but like, I guess I'm trying to say that from where I am today, if I You know what? It's just something to think about, you know, because at the end of the day, running up money is what poker's all about. It's about winning money. It's about making money, but it's also about winning money. And you know what? In order to get big, you gotta take bigger risks. You know what I'm saying? And for some reason right now, I just feel like I'm not risking enough. Is that weird? I don't think it's weird. I've taken risks since I moved to Vegas, and some of them have made things tight, and some of them have worked out pretty well. When I moved to my new apartment, it was a risk, but everything worked out in such a way that it just worked out. You know what I mean? And when I came back from Aruba, I was on the verge, like on a very fine line of things being, you know, really shitty or really good. And then the 100 hours challenge, as we called it at MGM Grand, well, that worked out fantastic. You know, I won a total of 4,700 and change in those 100 hours. And that, combined with a couple of other things, has just made everything a lot better right now. So I can breathe at the moment. But, you know, a lot of people say you can't make a living at 1-2 and 1-3. I disagree with that. I do believe that it's difficult. I think that it's a tough thing to do. I think that most people, even professional poker players, underestimate variance and underestimate what the long term is in poker. And I think there are a lot of people who underestimate just how break even or losing the best player in the world can be over the course of a year or even two. And I'm talking about full years, 2,000 hour years. You know what I mean? And so it's all risky. You know what I'm saying? And if I did something like what I just mentioned earlier, it would be sort of like a short term, I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about here. I guess I'm just saying that variance and chance is gonna come into the short term. And in any given week, month, or even year, variance can take over and control how much money one wins or makes at poker. Well, wins at poker. Make is theoretical, win is actual dollars that you end up with at the end of the period of time, whether it be a session, a week, a month, or a year. Trooper, what the hell are you saying here? Exit. No, I'm not saying exit. I'm saying that I'm having some brainstorms, I'm having some thoughts. I want things to be a certain way. I want things to go a certain way. And I want the vlog to be exciting, and we're gonna try some different shit. I just don't know what, and I don't know when. Let me think about it. But remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, leave a comment down below. I'll see you next time.